When the world's first offshore wind farm, Vindeby, was commissioned in September 1991, it provided clean and green energy to almost 2,200 households. With its 11 wind turbines and a total capacity of 5 megawatts, located northwest of the island of Lolland in the southern part of Denmark, it marked the first step taken to reap the huge offshore wind potential. Despite the wind farm's modest size, it has helped pave the way for large-scale Danish exports and job creation, enabling Danish suppliers and sub-suppliers to gain a strong position in the wind turbine industry.
Vindeby has been a really good proof of concept of offshore wind, and it lasted 25 years. And when making the decision to take it down, we looked at both the technical and the financial aspects. And as they were found to be worn out, especially the gearboxes, that decision was actually pretty easy based on the financials in the project.
Wind power translates into non-polluting electricity generation, and bringing it offshore offers countless siting possibilities and up to 50% more energy generation than a corresponding onshore wind turbine, which in turn increases its environmental value. But major challenges were associated with moving the wind turbines offshore. The wind turbines had to be protected from corrosion, and they were therefore equipped with dehumidifiers and heat exchangers and coated with anti-corrosive paint. These measures were the recipe for success, and the solution continues to be a basic principle in the design of offshore wind turbines. But now the turbines are being taken down, after more than 25 years of operation, which is much longer than anyone dared hope for. With water depths between 2 and 5 meters, all work must be carried out using relatively small vessels. In the planning phase, we have put great emphasis on minimizing the environmental impact, both in relation to the onshore residents and the animal and plant life in the area. When the wind turbines were erected in 1991, they were lifted into place in one piece. Today, however, we start by removing one blade, then the nacelle together with the remaining blades, and finally the tower, and everything is loaded onto a barge for transportation. This is done using a mobile crane mounted on a jack-up vessel. The foundations are concrete gravity foundations. They were cast on shore and afterwards sailed out to be placed on the seabed. However, because the foundations weigh up to 480 tons each, they have to be cut into smaller parts. This is done using milling equipment and hydraulic demolition shears. The concrete elements are subsequently collected and placed on a barge for transportation. At the same time as the foundations are broken down one by one, the cables between the wind turbines and the cable to the wind farm are removed. With the exception of one single turbine, which has been donated to the Danish Museum of Energy, all the dismantled components and foundations will be sent to Nyborg Harbour for reuse, either as spare parts for other wind turbines or as recyclable material which is transported to certified recovery companies. But before this happens, some wind turbine components are sent for further testing. Technical University of Denmark and various companies we use parts of the wind turbines to study the lifetime of the wind turbine components.
The concrete of the Vindeby Havmølle Park is of interest for me because it's 25 years old concrete that has been exposed in marine environment. So I can make analysis of the concrete that can tell me something about the durability, especially the chloride ingress. And we can use that to refine our models of chloride ingress in concrete that we use to predict the service life of concrete structures.
Originally, technicians doubted whether the wind turbines were able to withstand the harsh seawater environment, but Vindeby exceeded all expectations.
Vindeby has been really important for the offshore wind industry, as it was the world's first offshore wind park. And it has spurred the industry to look to sea, to look to the stable and high winds that you find out there. So it's been quite a remarkable development from a small demonstration project to actually being the cradle to where we are today.
Vindeby Offshore Wind Farm marked the first step on the journey. And since then, offshore wind farms have grown to become genuine power stations. Just to mention an example, Dong Energy's upcoming offshore wind farm, Hornsea Project 1, will be able to deliver green energy to approximately 1 million UK homes in 2020. But it all started with Vindeby.